So, the dev server for the upcoming update Direct Hit has arrived, and with it, new ships. I'll be going over all the tech tree ships, first going nation by nation, left to right. After this, I'll go over the premium ships and give them my opinion on whether I find them worth it or not. And to start it all off, USS Pittsburgh, our long-awaited tech tree Baltimore. In case you're not familiar with the Baltimore, it was an avant American heavy cruiser, which is well known for its heavy anti-air suite, consisting of 40 and 20mm guns. Pittsburgh is different in the sense that the heavy anti-air suite is changed to all rapid-fire 76mm guns. This is quite the upgrade in theory, but on the dev server these guns only have regular high explosive shells. But I'm quite confident that they'll get high explosive variable time fuse shells in the live server. In all other aspects, she's very much like the Baltimore, a decent US heavy cruiser. Next on the list we have the German M17, the tech tree counterpart of the premium M802. Because it's a tech tree equivalent, it has less anti-air weapons, as they do. The M17 doesn't have rapid-fire 37s, and doesn't have the double 20s, instead having single 20s either side of the bridge. It does retain its quadruple 20s, but that's the only thing that it retains. Other than the main armament, of course. I didn't check the damage model or spawn it has, but if they're identical to the M802, then M17 will be a tough nut to crack, with blue water damage model and a coastal spawn. Sure, it lacks the secondary weapons, but the primary 105s don't mess about either. It's a nice addition to the German coastal fleet and certainly fits with the line of barges, which it is a part of. The Russians get another battleship, and it further pushes the capability of battleships, but in a different way than the Japanese Hyuga did. Pryshkaya Komuna carries the same main armament as the Maria and Poltava, but where she differs is mainly her anti-air, as she's the first battleship with actually dangerous anti-aircraft capabilities. She carries 6 76mm guns grouped on the bridge and the rear tower, which are armed with high explosive time fuse shells. There are also 16 37mm guns, 3 on each main gun turret, and 4 on the rear mast. And then there's also 12 Dishka 50 cals spread on the bridge and the rear tower. This anti-air suite is definitely something to be wary of if you're a pilot. But she may have her weaknesses. Pryshkaya Komuna doesn't have coal bunkers, so doesn't get any extra protection from her fuel tanks. It's going to be interesting to see how she performs on the live servers. Next, we have a few British vessels, and I'll start with their coastal fleet edition, the Fairmile H. You're not seeing that wrong, that's a tank turret on a boat. But that's sadly where the fun ends. The tank turret isn't that powerful and has quite a low rate of fire. It's better to use the two 20mm guns as your primaries. This Fairmile H is also very slow and very large. Having next to no armor doesn't help either, nor does the 2.7 battle rating. I can see this thing easily going down in BR, but if it were to stay at 2.7, it's not going to be a very fun vessel to play. But in better news, the British are finally getting the reserve destroyer replaced. The HMS Churchill is getting removed from the tree for research, and in its place comes HMS Vega. It looks like a really promising reserve, really. These specific 102mm guns have a high rate of fire and decent firing arcs. The 420mm are nice as well, but not to be relied on for anti-air. But they're better than nothing. I'm really looking forward to this one, and I hope it'll bring more people into the British Blue Water tree. And finally, for the British tech tree vehicles, heavy cruiser Norfolk. Currently at the BR of 5.3 and coming after the Leander. It looks like a very nice British heavy cruiser. 8 203mm guns, a nice anti-air suite. By all accounts, a nice British cruiser. But I wouldn't be surprised if it were to move up to 5.7 in the near future. Next, we move to the Japanese Blue Water tree with Aoba, another heavy cruiser. Aoba is very similar to Furutaka with identical main armament and secondaries, but she carries a total of 50 25mm guns. That's quite a step up from Furutaka's 8. Other than that, mostly she's similar to Furutaka, but Aoba's torpedo tubes do have more restricted firing arcs, so keep that in mind. Visually, you can tell them apart by their turrets, superstructure and secondary smoke funnel. I'm personally looking forward to unlocking this cruiser. As for the last two tech tree ships, we move to Italy. Starting with the coastal fleet, they get Gabbiano. My apologies to the Italian language. She's a gunboat with complex damage models similar to the German M17 I discussed earlier. Gabbiano carries a single 100mm gun and 7 20mm guns. I highly suggest using the 20mm as your primary weapon, as the 100mm is rather lackluster. It's not as tough as the German M802, so don't think it's going to be quite as troublesome. And lastly, for the researchable ships, Leone, the Italian destroyer. She carries 8 120mm guns, which are identical to the reserve Turbine. They're decent guns, but I'm not sure if it's 4.7 worthy. Especially since Leone has next to no anti-aircraft firepower, or torpedoes. I wouldn't be shocked if we were to see this destroyer at 4.3, but I'm not expecting it either. It's probably going to be a bit of a struggle bus, but we'll have to see. And now, the premiums. Again, going nation by nation, left to right. So first, Karlsruhe. A premium German scout cruiser. It's basically just a Köln, but with more anti-air. I'm not familiar with playing these German cruisers, but I do know from facing them that their guns are quite powerful. But they do have their weaknesses. I don't know if Karlsruhe is worth the asking price of 4,880 Golden Eagles, but it is a ship with which you can research the entire German Blue Water Fleet, so certainly keep an eye on it. The next premium ship to look at is the Russian Smelyi, basically a premium PR-30. It has upgraded anti-air, but not by just adding guns, but by actually changing it a bit. Smelyi also has a very nice camouflage in my opinion. I'm not too familiar with the PR-30s, but I quite like the look of this premium ship. And with a cost of only 1,000 Golden Eagles, it's not too expensive either. Especially for a ship that'll help you unlock half the Russian Blue Water Tree. If you haven't gone up the Russian Blue Water Tree yet, and you want a premium ship to boost your progress somewhat, Smelyi certainly looks like a nice choice. And now we have the British, or should I say Irish, EL Orla, a premium Peacock class which gets some additional guns. Mainly two rapid-fire 20mm guns which can also be found on late German tanks like the Marder IFVs. It's a nice addition on a Peacock, as using the main gun for anti-air could rapidly dwindle the small ammo load of the 76mm gun. But even though this is nice, it in no way justifies a BR of 4.0, nor a price of almost 7,500 Golden Eagles. Orla is not worth that money, it is not capable of holding its own at 4.0 even in the slightest, and that price is just a straight ripoff. Even if it had a better BR. If you listen to just even one thing I say in this video, then please listen to this. Do not buy Orla, you will not enjoy it. But lastly, to end on a lighter note, Yubari. The ship we saw on the dev blogs. It's a 4.7 cruiser, as I expected it to be, but I wouldn't recommend it. It's a rank 3 and not too expensive at a price of 1,750 Golden Eagles, but the guns are somewhat lackluster, the armor is paper thin, and she's the slowest cruiser the Japanese have. I'll personally get it, as I am a collector of Japanese ships, but I can't recommend anyone get it if they plan to grind with it. That's all for the new ships. Expect another video soon though on some of the changes to Naval. Goodbye, and may the seas be calm.